Hi everybody, welcome to Shell Lectures. So today we'll be dealing with direct and indirect speech for the conversion of sentences in present continuous, past continuous and future continuous. From direct speech to indirect speech. So today we are going to learn how the sentences in present continuous, past continuous and future continuous in the direct speech get converted into their indirect speech. So let me write a sentence first. Ram said to Raj, comma inverted comma, I am reading a book now. So let's recall the rules. First of all, when a sentence like this is given to you, you have to look into the sentence which is given inside the double quotes. So here it is, I am reading a book now. So it's none other than present tense, because am is there and then we have ing, so it's nothing but present continuous tense, right? So we already know the rule that present changes into past tense and past tense changes into past perfect. Just we can remember that, but we are not going to apply it at first though. But still, I am reminding you of that rule, okay? Because that rule plays a role. Of course, that rule plays a role in every sentences, but here we should not get confused. So first of all, the first rule, as we all know earlier, the sentence within the double quote should be a, if it is an assertive sentence, then you have to go with the first row. If it is an interrogative sentence, then you have to go with the second row. If it's imperative, then third row. If it's exclamatory, then the fourth row. So this is assertive because it's just a statement. So let me go with the first row. So what is the rule in the first row? The subject should be written as it is. And if it is said to, it must be changed into told. And if it is just said, I have to retain it as said, right? So here I have said to. So let me write told. Ram told Raj. Okay, so then we write a conjunction which is indispensable for a sentence. And for assertive sentence, what is a conjunction that we use in indirect speech? Yeah, that's that. Okay, so the word is that. So Ram told Raj that. Then you have to change the pronoun. Here it's I am reading a book now. So this I refers to Ram. So it will change into he, right? Okay, Ram is a boy, so it just changes into he. Ram told Raj that he. And then you write am reading. What is that? Am reading. Am is in present tense, right? So it's present continuous. So I told you that present tense changes into past tense and past tense changes into past perfect. So this is present tense. Let's just assume it to be present. So it changes into past. So here it's present continuous. So it changes into past continuous. So let me write he was, because he is singular here. So I've written was, and then he was reading a book. So now the word now changes into then in indirect speech. Now let me write another sentence. So the sentence is Sanjay said, comma inverted comma, they were cooking a delicious meal. So this sentence, when we convert it into past, we have to check the sentence which is inside the quotation. So it's just an assertive sentence because it's just a statement. So let me go with the first row. So writing the subject as it is, and if the reporting verb is said, I have to write said again. If it is said to, I have to change it into told, right? So Sanjay said, and then I write the conjunction which is there for assertive sentence, that is that. And then I write the pronoun. So here, the word they neither refers to Sanjay because he is just a person. So if it had been I, then it would have referred to Sanjay. But here it's they. So he itself is talking about some kind of a third person. So in the answer also, you must retain the third person as third person because he is the third person to you also. So Sanjay said that they, and then we have were cooking, ing, past continuous, right? So that must be changed to present to past, past to past perfect. So what is the structure for past perfect? Had plus been plus verb plus ing. So had been, what is the verb here? Cooking. Had been cooking a delicious meal. Okay, a delicious meal. next sentence is Rahul said comma inverted comma I will be writing my exam at this time tomorrow. So here also let's look at a sentence which is inside the quotation, that is just a statement, right? So it's assertive. So let me go with the first row. Let me write the subject as it is. So I write Rahul and then I write the reporting verb that is said, because it's just said and it's not said to someone. So I write said. Then I write the conjunction which is meant for assertive sentences, that is that. And then here the word I refers to Rahul, because Rahul said I will be writing, so that I refers to Rahul, so let me write he here instead of I. So Rahul said that he, and I told you earlier that modal verbs in direct speech will get converted into their past forms in the indirect speech. The modal verbs are can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, ought to, need to, dare to and must. So here we have will, so it will change into would. He would be writing. Again, we have one more change here. Writing my exam. Does this mean I am going to write, he is going to write my exam? No, right? It's just referring again to Rahul. So, my will change into his exam. Writing his exam at this time. So, tomorrow will change into the following day. The following day. As now changes into then, tomorrow changes into following day, and yesterday changes into the day before or the previous day. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel if you have not done so far. Like and share this video to whomever you know. Thank you.